Namaskar. Today we will be visiting one of the most stunning twin temple complex in the heart of Nagpur. We will be joined by a bright architect and heritage enthusiast, Prachi Sharma, who will be explaining the architectural intricacies of the temple complex. Interested? So join us as we explore this architectural marvel in Mahal Nagpur. It was built around 1780 to 1800 in the era of Raghuji Bhosle II of the Bhosle dynasty. Raghuji II is fondly remembered as the architect of Nagpur. The glorious 28 years of his rule is considered to be the golden period, and a lot of architectural activity in this region happened during his reign. After passing through this historical Shukravari gate, we walked straight till we reached this marvelous landmark, the Srimant Deshmukh Wada. Just opposite to it, in the narrow lane, we saw this sandstone gate. As we entered, we were stunned by what unfolded in front of us. In the middle of a big courtyard, there was a marble baradari, which served as a seating for the rulers of the Bhosle dynasty.
A very peculiar feature of this temple is that over a stone plinth, marble was used for the very first time.
In front of the baradari is a tank where there used to be a fountain, and behind it is a beautiful Shiva temple known as Raghu Rajeshwar Mahadev Mandir after Raghuji Raje. The shikhar of the temple is of North Indian style, but the Sabha Mandap is an excellent example of Bhosle era architecture. In the courtyard are temples of Sri Ganesh and Bajrangbali. The unique idol of Sri Ganesh is with the trunk curved to the right, and he has a beaded necklace in his left hand. Now, Ganesh festival used to be celebrated for 10 days in this premises with lots of fanfare.
The temple has predominantly two materials, stone and wood. The plinth of the temple is made out of entirely local stone which was available at that time, and the columns are carved out of single wood. All the columns are quite intricately carved with features on the brackets and on the top, as you can see.
The Garbhagriha has a Shivling and marble idols of Ganpati, Naga and Annapurna. The Shivling known as Raghu Rajeshwar is unique as it is made up of three coloured marbles. On the right side of the Garbhagriha is a Gaumukh. As you stand in the courtyard, the shikhar of the Lakshmi Narayan temple is clearly visible. So there is a Vaishnav temple besides a Shaiv temple in the Rukmini complex. This can be seen in other temples built during the Bhosle era too. At one end of the courtyard was this old wooden frame door, which opened into another courtyard with the Lakshmi Narayan temple, and popularly known as the Jai Singh Bhosle Parisar. Similar to the Baradari of the Raghu Rajeshwar temple was a small marble temple with features of the Dravidian style of architecture. On the shikhar was a statue in which a flame used to be burning in those days. The Sabha Mandap has intricately carved pillars and arches typical of the Bhosle era. Similar to the Gomukh at the Shiv temple is a marble crocodile. As we went around the temple, we were mesmerized by the magnificence. The carvings of the temple are just spectacular.
The elements of this temple are beautifully carved, and if you see closer, you're going to see the niches between these, the detailing on the corners, and makes you wonder about the structural ability of the rulers at that time. As you start looking at this temple closer, is that if you see this entire carving, you're going to find that there are two different elements which are used here. But as soon as you try to find the same element being repeated in other part, if you look at this one, you will find that the carving inside the same module has changed. Similarly, in this one, the carving of the temple remains the same, but the element inside has changed. And if you see here, again, it's changed. If you move to another part to find continuity, you won't find any.
Every inch of the temple is beautifully carved. You can imagine how depressing it was to see the beautiful sculptures being used to hang plastic bags and clothes. It's a stunning piece of art, and shouldn't we be preserving them for the future generations? Garbhagriha has marble idols of Lakshmi Narayan. Puja is offered every day till this day. On coming out, in front was this small marble temple which housed Garud. Now the question is, why is this place called Rukmini Mandir? History has it that it was named after Rukmini Devi, who was a courtesan in the times of Raghuji III, the last Sena Sahib Subha. Behind me, you can see a closed door which opens in the Bhosle Rajwada, and the royals as well as Rukmini Devi would enter from this gate. Through this shut door, I travelled back to the golden era when the Bhosles ruled here. I imagine Rukmini Devi walking in through the door, the royal sitting in the Baradari, fountains playing, the mashal burning on the top of the Shikhar, and Ganesh Chaturthi being celebrated with fanfare. Now, the Bhosle dynasty of Nagpur has played a very important role in the history of Madhya Bharat, and these intricate carvings have witnessed a lot, including a grand palace burning down to ashes. These neglected structures, which once stood with pride, are now lost in the surrounding concrete jungle. Do they not need our urgent attention so that they are not lost in history? The purpose of making this video is to make more people aware of this glorious heritage. So if you like this video, please like and share it. Friends, With the promise to come back soon with more hidden gems of the Bhosle era, it's time to say goodbye. See you soon.